Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Here in this video I will cover SSC GE 2018 solution, exam date 25th January 2018 second shift. This is part 3 of this video series. Question is, the flow through a turbine in a Mollier diagram is represented by a in Mollier diagram flow through turbine. So first in TS plot I will do, then HS plot for Mollier diagram. So TS plot you will get like this. Constant pressure line, two constant pressure lines. Like this, pressure constant. Here also pressure constant. Then you start from pump, pressure 1 to isentropic heat addition. Sorry, this is isentropic pressure. You are increasing the pressure from P1 to P2. Then 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition. 2 to 3. Then 3 to 4 isentropic expansion. 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, 4 to 1 condensation or phase change. So 3 to 4 it represents turbine. In HS plot, Mollier diagram, we'll do 3 to Mollier diagram or HS plot. You will get constant pressure lines here like this. They are straight lines. Then after saturated vapor line, it's diverging. It will go like this. Constant pressure lines. So here pressure is constant, pressure is constant, pressure is constant. This one is here saturated vapor line. So this region is liquid plus vapor region, this region is vapor region. And here one more thing also important, constant temperature line. Constant temperature line, liquid vapor region same as constant pressure line. And in superheated vapor region, it will go like this. Temperature is constant. Temperature is constant. So, already discussed this one. Constant pressure is reducing from P2 to P4. So, here P3 or P2 both are same pressure. Pressure is reducing, isentropic process. So here you will get like this. Three to four. Isentropic expansion process in turbine. 3 to 4. Pressure is reducing. P3, let this is P3. P3 to P4. So from options we will check flow through a turbine. It's a vertical line. 4 is your correct answer. Curved line convex up, this one. Pressure constant. Or your heat addition in boiler. Or in condenser, heat rejection in condenser. And curved line convex down. This one temperature is constant, constant temperature lines. And both are in superheated region only. Other region, in liquid vapor region, both are straight lines. Next question, dash is present in high percentage in magnet steel. Magnet steel, aluminum, tungsten, zinc and copper. Official answer is this one, tungsten. Foundry crucible is made of Graphite, yes. One is your correct answer. Corundum contains more than 95% MgO, SiO2, L2O3. It should be O3. 3 is your correct answer. It's very hard. Pipes of bicycle frames are made of dash steel. Cast, no. Hot rolled, no. Carbon chrome, yes. Carbon chrome steel. Austenite is a solid solution of carbon in dash iron. It's alpha. So alpha you will get in ferrite, alpha ferrite. Austenite you will get gamma. Question is, dash will exhibit viscoelastic behavior. Viscoelastic behavior means it is having both viscous behavior and elastic behavior. So from option we will check, steel no, diamond also not possible, neoprene, 4 is your correct answer. Out of the following, which is the amorphous material? This one same question they asked in ISRO Scientist 2018 also. Lead, brass, glass. Glass is the correct answer. Alloys of magnesium are, magnesium is, alloy, magnesium alloy is very lightweight. So, we are using automobile component also. Light, 3 is your correct answer. That's why we are using in making of automobile component, camera body also. Question is, under microscope, perlite appears as, perlite is alternate lamina of ferrite and cementite. White, light, dark, fingerprint. In fingerprint also you will get alternate layers. So like that there also you will get alternate lamina of ferrite and cementite. You will get 0.8% carbon eutectate reaction, product is perlite. Austenite converted to perlite or ferrite plus cementite. At 0.8% carbon reaction is eutectate reaction. Dash has maximum malleability. Aluminium, copper, lead, wrought iron. Official answer is lead. A fluid is said to be ideal if it is zero viscosity. Zero viscosity means incompressible also possible. Inviscous both 1 and 2. So inviscous and incompressible. Fourth is your best option. Question is, which of the following is dimensionless? Specific weight is rho into g, your unit. If you can check this one, it's having unit also, rho, kg per meter cube, g is acceleration unit. Then this one is not dimensionless. Specific volume also, volume per unit mass, specific speed, ns also. For a turbine you will get h to the power 5 by 4, n is 1 by s, power is force into velocity. Then h also, it's having unit head, specific gravity, yes, density of fluid by density of ideal fluid. So density both unit will cancel, this one unitless. Fourth is your correct answer. In the figure given above, the ideal fluid curve that is applicable, zero shear stress, velocity gradient, or d theta by dt also you can write, shear strain rate, d theta by dt, velocity gradient is dv by dy. Ideal fluid, here you will get ideal fluid, zero shear stress or inviscid, This one for Newtonian fluid. This one n is less than 1. Pseudoplastic. So ideal fluid, options we will check. For ideal fluid, A is your ideal fluid. So from option we will check, option number 1. This one is your correct answer. Question is, surface tension has the unit of surface tension, force per unit length. So Newton per meter. 3 is your correct answer. Force unit is Newton, then length unit is meter. Alcohol is used as manometer because it has low vapor pressure, it's clearly visible, it has low surface tension, it can provide longer column due to low density. Yes. Fourth one is your correct answer. Low vapor pressure in case of mercury will get. Poise is the unit of poise, CGS unit. Unit of dynamic viscosity or simply viscosity. 1 poise. Dyne per centimeter square into second. Or 1 poise equal to 1 by 10 Pascal second or 1 by 10 Pascal is Newton per meter square into second. Question is, the angle of contact in case of a liquid depends upon a nature of liquid and solid. Yes, this is correct. The material which exists above the free surface of liquid, this one also correct. So both are correct. Only A, only B, both A and B. 3 is your correct answer. Next question. To avoid vaporization in the pipeline over the reach is laid such that it's not more than 2.4 meter above the hydraulic gradient line. HGL. 6.4 meter above hydraulic gradient. Yes, this one is correct. 6.4 meter above the hydraulic gradient. Capillary action is due to both cohesion and adhesion. So from option we will check. Surface tension, cohesion of liquid, adhesion of liquid molecules on the surface of solid. 2 also possible, 3 also possible. So all options are correct. 4 is your correct answer. If here you will get both cohesion and adhesion, then you have to answer this one. Next question. Question is, which of the following instrument can be used for measuring speed of a submarine moving in deep sea? Venturimeter, orifice plate, no, pitot tube. Or none of the above, pitot tube. Pitot tube not available, so none of these. This is the answer. Question is, the continuity equation in a fluid flow, continuity equation, conservation of mass, states that the energy is constant along streamline. This is for Bernoulli's equation. Then states that the energy is constant everywhere in the fluid, applied to irrotational flow only. States that the net rate of inflow into small volume must be zero. Yes. Fourth one is your correct option. Question is, in series pipe application, Q equal to Q1 equal to Q2 equal to Q3. Then for HF equivalent or HF equal to HF1 plus HF2 plus HF3, like this. This is for series connection. And for parallel connection, Q equivalent, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, like this. HF, it's equal to HF1, HF2, it's equal to HF3. Head loss represented by HF, and Q is your mass flow rate. So from option we will check series of pipe application, head losses through each pipe are added to obtain the total head loss. Total head loss is HF. So added, yes, in series we are adding. One is your correct option. Then head loss is same through the each pipe, this one for parallel connection. Friction factors are assumed for each pipe, flow increases. Option 1 is your correct option. Hydraulic diameter used in place of diameter of non-circular duct is equal to hydraulic diameter 4a by p. Cross sectional area by perimeter, weighted perimeter. Here in this question m is available, so replace with m. 4a by m. 2 is your correct answer. Question is, hydraulic ram is a device used to accelerate water flow, lift water without electric motor. For lifting heavy loads, beat water and lift it. Yes. Fourth one is your correct option. In a free vortex motion, the tangential velocity of water particles is proportional to free vortex flow. Net external torque is no external torque added applied. So here no external, V into R is constant, or in case of forced vortex flow, you will get V by R is constant. This one for free vortex motion. So here R is the distance from center, tangential velocity, V is inversely proportional to R, or V into R is constant. So only C, 3 is your correct option. Euler's equation in the differential form for the motion of liquids is given by Euler's equation. You will get dp by rho plus g dz plus v dv, it's equal to 0. This is Euler's equation. If you integrate this one, you will get Bernoulli's equation. P by rho plus gz plus v square by 2, it's equal to 0. Or you can write it as like this also, p by rho g z plus v square by 2g, it's equal to 0. Sorry, this one it will become constant. So from here we will check dp by rho plus gdz plus vdv. And Euler's equation conditions are flow is inviscid. This is also very very important. C is your correct, or only C, 3 is your correct option. Question is, as pump speed increases, its net positive suction head requirement may increase, decrease depending on other considerations. Fourth is your correct option. Question is, the frictional resistance of a pipe varies approximately as frictional resistance. It's B square. So from option only B. 2 is your correct option. Velocity of pressure waves due to pressure disturbances imposed in a fluid is equal to E is your bulk modulus and rho is your density. V equal to K by rho root over. Here instead of K, E is available for bulk modulus, so E by rho root over. From option we will check A, only A. Option 1. V is your velocity of pressure waves. Question is, for a siphon to work satisfactorily, the minimum pressure in the pipe as compared to vapor pressure of liquid should be, it should be greater than vapor pressure of liquid. If you take a siphon like this, summit point. This is your outlet. This one is your summit point, highest point. So here summit pressure PS, it should be greater than your vapor pressure PV. Because if summit pressure is less than PV, then air lock formation will occur. So to avoid that one, to avoid air lock formation, PS at summit, it should be greater than PV, vapor pressure. So here vapor pressure available, minimum pressure in pipe is your, at summit only you will get minimum pressure. So PS, minimum we will write, it should be greater than PV. Option 1 is your correct answer. Question: if the magnitude of water hammer does not depend upon magnitude of water hammer, temperature of fluid, length of pipe, elastic properties of pipe metal, time of valve closure. Answer is temperature of fluid. Question is, an air vessel is usually provided at the summit of a siphon. Already discussed summit point. Air vessel usually provided at the summit of a siphon. Regulate the flow, increase discharge to avoid interruption in flow. Yes, 3 is your correct answer. The discharge over a B notch wire is proportional to H to the power 5 by 2. But in case of rectangular, it will come 3 by 2. 2 is your correct option. This one for rectangular. This one also important. Triangular and V notch, you will get this one. Proportional to H to the power 5 by 2. So from option 2 is your correct. In an external mouthpiece, value of coefficient of discharge if pipe is flowing full will be how much? CD value. CD value normally it will come 0.62. So from option we will check. Option 1 is your correct option. Coefficient of discharge or CD. When the depth of water in an open channel is greater than the critical depth of flow, then flow is critical depth, then the flow is said to be. So depth is greater than your critical depth. This one already explained in my previous video. D versus Q graph. Q is discharge, D is depth of flow. Rod number you will get. So graph will become like this. Q max point, maximum mass flow rate. This point you will get critical, D critical. So here critical depth, depth of water is greater than critical depth. So this area, you name it ABC, it's between AB. So here AB you will get, Froude number will come at critical point, Froude number is equal to 1, and above it Froude number is less than 1. Here it will get Froude number is greater than 1. Then subcritical or this region A to B, it's subcritical or tranquil region. Subcritical or tranquil, both names you have to remember. Here you will get critical, supercritical region. This one is your, at B point when Froude number will become 1 and Q is maximum, depth is critical depth, there you will get critical. B point is your critical point, C to B supercritical region, A to B is your subcritical or tranquil region. So from option D is greater than your critical depth, so in AB region it will come subcritical or tranquil flow. Subcritical word not available here, tranquil. For critical, you will get forward number rate equal to 1 or D equal to D critical. Maximum mass flow rate also. This one already discussed. The discharge through a rectangular notch. Q is proportional to h to the power 3 by 2. And Q is proportional to h to the power 5 by 2 for triangular or B notch. 3 is your correct answer. The width of the wire with end contraction is less than the width of the channel is. 1 is your correct answer. Weber number. Weber number is the ratio of inertial force to force due to surface tension. For gravitational force, you will get Froude number. Then elasticity, here you will get Mach number. For viscosity, inertia force by viscous force, you will get Reynolds number. So, inertia force to surface tension, 2 is your correct answer. The average value of coefficient of velocity is the order of coefficient of velocity, CV. It's around 0.95 to 0.99. So from option we will check none of the fourth one is a correct option. In order that no shock wave develops when the flow is taking place through a converging diverging tube, Mach number at exist should be. So it's a converging and diverging tube, converging like this, then diverging. Converging diverging tube. Mach number at exist, it should be greater than 1. So from option we will check 3 is your correct option. Question is, equivalent evaporation is the amount of water vapor evaporated in a boiler from and at. Equivalent evaporation 100 degree Celsius. 2 is your correct answer. On Mollier chart, flow throughout the turbine is represented by, this one already discussed, HS diagram, Mollier diagram or Mollier chart, HS plot. This is your saturated vapor line. And this region is liquid plus vapor, this region is vapor region. Here you will get constant pressure line like this. In liquid vapor region, you will get parallel lines. But after that, diverging. In temperature lines, constant temperature lines, here in liquid vapor region, you will get like this. Then like this you will get. Temperature is constant, here pressure is constant. So here we have to check the turbine. Turbine is isentropic process. Pressure is constant. You will get like this, 1 to 2. This one represents isentropic expansion in turbine. Vertical straight line, 1 to 2, vertical straight line. 2 is your correct answer. Question is, the evaporation of 15.653 kg of water per hour from and at 100 degree Celsius is called as evaporation of 15.653 kg of water per hour from and at 100 degree Celsius. It's 1 boiler horsepower. Fourth one is your correct option. steam engine operates on first law of thermodynamics cycle is your Rankine cycle. Rankine cycle, first law of thermodynamics, conversion of heat to work. So from option, none of these, fourth one is your correct option. The number of drums in Benson steam generator is, number of Benson steam generator, once through boiler. So you will not get a drum. In water valve panel itself, complete conversion of water to steam is possible. So Benson steam generator, once through boiler, no drum. Fourth one is your correct option. Question is, the pressure in kg per centimeter square and temperature in degree Celsius at the end of compression stroke in a petrol engine are the order of. Official answer is second, 6 to 12 and 250 to 300 degree Celsius. A heat engine utilizes calorific value of oil, low heat value of oil, high heat value of oil, mean heat value of oil. Answer is high heat value of oil. 3 is your correct option. Question is, the reason for supercharging in any engine to increase efficiency, increase power, reduce weight and bulk for a given output? Yes. Third one is your correct option. Question is, the following volume in meter cube of air is required for consuming 1 liter of fuel by a 4-stroke engine is? Official answer is 9 to 10. Fourth one is your correct option. Question is, isooctane has octane number 100. 3 is your correct answer. Isooctane plus N-heptane octane number deals with pre-ignition. Octane number deals with pre-ignition. And your C10 number deals with ignition delay. And octane number, isooctane plus N-heptane. This is the end of this part. 25th January 2018 paper. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.